Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see what is the days. Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see what is the DATESINPERIOD function in DAX. And using this function, there are many other things you can do. And widely, this function is used to calculate moving averages. Let's see how it will help the Naga Garments business. We are trying to understand DAX functions using a business scenario, Naga Garments. And today he has a question like how to calculate cumulative or moving averages of sales. Let's try to see it in demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We are in Power BI desktop right now, and let us try to understand date at function before going to dates in period, what it does. In our previous video, we have already seen it, but what date at does. So date at is like it will get a date and it will get a relative period. And what is that period? It can be a day, year, or month. So now in this case, for March 2016, it goes and refer 2 months back and gets the data. So for March, it's January data. Say for example, August, this is the data, and it will go and fetch June data here. The June data is available here. So it reference single point. But what does dates in period does is it does the cumulative. Say like on March, I want January, February, March. Okay. On April, I want February, March, April. That is 3 months cumulative. It will should keep on adding the total. So how to do it? The dates in period is the answer. Let us try to create a dates in period measure. I'll say 3 months cumulative total. Okay, just name it like that. Total sales. So all it begins with calculate. Let me zoom the measure so that you guys can view it properly. So calculate sum of I already created a measure for it, total sales. Total sales, comma, and dates in period. So dates in period, to explain with, it takes the date and start date and number of intervals. So if we have only the start date and we need to go relative period like my three months back or 12 months cumulative, you need to use dates in period. So dim date comma start date is last date of dim date dot date. I used last date here since for this particular month, okay, when you see this chart here, so it will take this last date, okay, this particular date is considered as last date. So for each filter context, it will start working. That is the thing. So that's why I mentioned last date. So let's close this one, last date, comma, relative period is 3, okay. And I want interval as month. Okay, let us put enter and 3 month cumulative total. Let us try to search. I hope it was clear. Let us zoom out. So basically it does wrong calculation since, hold on, so I need to put minus 3 here. Okay, now you see the correct thing. That's what I put wrongly. So you understand. It takes the future. If you are putting minus 3, it from this month, minus 3, something like that. So in this case, there is no previous month data. So it is same. And for this, if you sum up these two, you will get this, right? So if you see 550 plus 1, that is correct, okay? And for this, it is summing up these 3 months. And when you take April, it is sum of February, March, April, okay? That is what it is. So, and for May, it is April, March. So these 3 months total, we are summing up and we are seeing it here. So the thing what you need to understand is like, it is cumulative. When we will use it, if it is used to have a moving averages, how I am performing from the past 3 months compared to this month. So each 3 months, how I am progressing in order to get a cumulative averages. That is what a moving averages. So in this same measure, what I need to do is, so average is nothing but your sales divided by number of months or whatever calculation you are doing, number of items, right? That is your average. So let me take entire thing of this measure in variable as sum of total, okay, equals this one. And I have another variable count of month, okay? So let me take the entire query and put it here, okay? Instead of total, I want distinct count, okay? Distinct count of dim date dot date, okay? Let us say date. So here again I want number of days or the average, okay? I'm getting it for the 3 months. Now let us try to divide it. The sum divided by my count will give me the exact result. Sum total divided by count of month, okay, this one. Either I can use this one or I can use the divide function. That would be better. Alternate result, if something goes wrong, put it 0. There you go. So what happened? Again, there is an issue. So here I should not use the date. Instead, I need to use month, okay? Since I am using a month-wise average. There you go. I fixed it. So the average of these two is your 1577. And if you sum up these 3 months, your average comes over here. And when we keep going on May, it is sum of these three divided by your number of months. So that is 3 months. So this is what is expecting. He wants to see the cumulative average. I should rename it as 3 months cumulative average. So for this purpose only, we need to go for dates in period. And this is not the only purpose. So such an example like this, usually we'll go for dates in period. If you like this video, share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.